Governor Rick Perry vowed mob tactics won't stop state government. Perry made the promise at the National Right to Life Convention in North Texas today and signaled the fight over abortions will continue in Austin. Fox 4's Sean Rabb was there.
Particularly glad to see all of you this week, of all weeks.
That was the last lighthearted comment from Governor Rick Perry addressing the National Right to Life Convention. He turned to Tuesday night, the Senate chamber.
As we witnessed the very extremes that the pro-abortion forces will resort to in order to further their cause.
Hundreds of shouting pro-choice advocates filled the chamber.
They'll resort to mob tactics to force their minority agenda on the people of Texas.
Order could never be restored. The Senate could not vote on Senate Bill 5, which would ban abortions after 20 weeks.
But what we witnessed Tuesday was nothing more than the hijacking of the democratic process.
And the hijacker? Perry says State Senator Wendy Davis. Davis of Fort Worth filibustered Tuesday. Today, Perry told her coming from difficult circumstances being a teen mother story, yet succeeding to serve in the Texas Senate.
It's just unfortunate that she hasn't learned from her own example.
Meeting with reporters, Perry continued on Davis.
But she didn't come from particularly good circumstances. What if her mom had said, you know, I just can't do this. I don't want to do this.
Davis responded in a written statement, saying Rick Perry's statement is without dignity and tarnishes the high office he holds. They're small words, she continued, that reflect a dark and negative point of view. Our governor should reflect our Texas values. Sadly, Governor Perry fails that test. But those here for the convention, many from out of state, sided with the governor and not with the woman who stood 11 hours in a political standoff that cast her in the national spotlight.
It's an injustice, and so it's good that, you know, they will get another chance to address that and hopefully be a voice for the, you know, for the voiceless.
The governor conceding he lost the battle of the first special session, but not the war on Senate Bill 5.
We will ban abortion after 20 weeks.
And Steve, some of our social media people just handed this to me. In the last few minutes, State Senator Wendy Davis posted this on her Facebook page.
Ratcheting up the response a little bit, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. She says she's now saddened to learn that the governor, Governor Perry, made the shameful decision, is what she calls it today, to personally attack me and my family. That's a quote. She goes on to say, Texans deserve better than a governor who tells women, including myself, she says, how they should live their lives. So the war of words, indeed. The shots across the bow and the response, and wait till next week when it goes down again.
Right. Because she responded. In your story, you have the response, and she's ratcheted it up. It's ratcheting up. All right, let's talk about next week and what we might expect. Last night, Senator Royce West said he invited people to show up. And if they do show up in the chamber, are they prepared for that in Austin this time?
Right. Well, what he said is if you care about it, either way, show up.
Right.
And yes, they are prepared. I've been talking to people in the Lieutenant Governor's office, and they tell me they're not going to let it get out of hand again. If there are huge crowds, great. But if those crowds begin to lift their voices inside the chamber, that the chamber will be cleared and there will be decorum as this SB5 plays out over the next couple of weeks. The vote's not going to come until after the 4th of July holiday weekend.
Okay. All right. It's already started, though.
Yes, it has.
All right. Sean Rapp, thank you.
Sure.